what I was talking about mind invasion and demons and aliens or whatever they're trying to use to communicate with me, combined with modern technology and telepathy with perhaps cults or psychics. These people originally seemed like a cult when they invaded my mind in December one evening, because you could just almost feel them as a group, like feel the energy and the evil in them as they were connecting as a force, like one big superior force connecting their minds. But now it seems so much more advanced, because last night when that force had multiplied and there seemed to be more of them, they were too quick to respond to me, too quick to, they reacted quicker than any computer. It was like no human can react that quickly, but yet they seem like humans. As they're doing, trying to communicate with me through modern weapons and these new inventions, they seem like they're human. But maybe these, whatever is happening, can masquerade humans, be that deceptive. Okay, right now, they're trying to send me to a foreign country. And a few years ago, if everything had been perfect here and there was no risk in going, and everybody wouldn't have threatened my domain while I was away or promised bodily harm if I left, I would have gone to this country. You know, they stole my passport after I booked a hotel and bought a winter wardrobe to go, because the climate's very cold there and I didn't have enough winter clothes. You know, I would have been there. And after they prevented me from going, they said it was to save my life. Well, now they're trying to get me to go. See, when my mind was stronger last year, which I thought was terribly weak because they've been breaking it down, I had enough force and energy to see this creature they wanted me to see. And it looked like a human one time. And it looked so much like the leader of the country I wanted to go to. The difference was it had pointy ears, and this leader does not have pointy ears. And his skin was more of a reddish tone. But one night when my head was felt like they were going to give me a cerebral hemorrhage, they were just like they were cracking it open. I felt like death. I felt like they were trying to kill me. I had the most powerful vision in my mind. And usually I can feel terror or I can feel spirits. Well, this night I actually saw a face. And it looked like this person. And this person was the most intelligent person. They had the knowledge of all the ages. They could see the past and they knew everything about the present more than anybody else. And they showed me like the universe. It was vast. I could see black, but mostly fire. And orange looked like volcano lava that was, I guess, the color of this universe that this person was looking at. And they wanted me to come and journey with them out into it to get to the other side and show me anything my mind wanted to know. And then all of a sudden, it was like a reel, like when you flash pictures across the screen real fast, back to back. I could see past, present, and future all at once. I could know anything that humanity ever wanted to know, and I would have been told the truth. It was like he was showing me all the knowledge in the universe. He was showing me the past, the ancient times, what happened in ancient times, all these ancient people. But he wanted to give me so much knowledge, I couldn't handle it. And he wanted me to get closer and closer into his realm and journey with him. And then I said, I can't. You offer me the universe, and it would be great to travel with you, but my mind isn't equipped to know these things. I don't want to know these things. I said, because I don't think God would want me to know these things, or he would have given me the brain to be able to acknowledge what you're trying to show me. And then I said, I can see everyone suffering. I can see the suffering through the ages, and I can see how one person's crime caused a penalty. But I can't go with you because I think you're the devil. And the devil may be nice, but there are consequences if I take your hand and go with you. And one of them is I lose my soul, and the other one is I lose all love. I said, and that love is something I'm not willing to part with. I said, I don't think you can love. I don't think maybe your soul is ever going to find peace in heaven. I said, but there are dead loved ones in heaven I want to see again. And if I go with you, I won't see them again. And then I just told that person that I really, really love them, but I couldn't go be with them. It was just out of my mind. And then after that, that's when they said, Justin called his father out of the blue. And he said, guess what? I'm coming to Kentucky. And he hadn't been here since he was 10. And he goes, I'm being flown there on government business. And after that, my garage door opener doors kept going up and down. And then they told me on the computer, because I refused to accept that winner takes all. And then they just made all these threats, winner takes all, because they said, I'm supposed to let this thing take me over. I'm supposed to let it in my whole being. And, you know, who knows what gave me that vision? Who knows if it was just something they made me imagine? Who knows if it's a real entity? Who knows if it was a spirit? I only know that I love God, and love is more important to me than anything on this earth. And heaven is more important to me than anything on this earth. And I don't care to know everything the universe has to offer. I don't care to know those secrets, because just what I saw was more than I could handle. And I think man is crazy to try to play around with all that knowledge. As you see, you can't combine it with humanity, because you're destroying humanity. You're creating hybrids. You're destroying our makeup. Everything you're doing today is destroying God's kingdom. So what in the world would a simple girl from Kentucky need with power like that? I love most of all, you know, and something else this person did. I love them for this. Oh my God. I love them for this. I could never repay them. They were so kind what they gave me on Easter. I was outside on Easter, and all of a sudden the universe just opened up to me, and I got to spend time with someone on the other side. And I got to go back and do something I did in childhood that was so rare, and I got to be with them. I got to have them console me and talk to me. I was so comforted, and I just felt so strong. And then afterward, I came in the house, and the leader of this country sent me a picture of himself with his arms around me, hugging me like a child. You know, and what am I going to do with that? I run. And you know, the reason I run is because if God wanted me to have these things, then he would tell me. But I'm afraid they've got my loved one, because they're telling me things that she says and does, and they're telling me that she don't like them, that she's fighting them, that she's cursing them, and that she hates them. She wants them to leave me alone. She told them to stop bothering me, and she really means it. And you know what else they said? She told them her favorite songs. No one knew. And they come and they give me messages from heaven of things that she said. Only her. Now, that would have to be some supernatural force. You know, how do they know what my mother wants?